Speaking during the burial prayers held today at Ajuri Primary School, the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, remembered the spontaneous personality of the late Jacob Olanya.
And he also showed me some bridges in Omoro. And it was a rainy season the time we visited Omoro. He told me that since you come from cabinet, you gather all these issues, not only of education, and take them to cabinet. That is the Right Honorable Jacob Olanya. He was an all-round thinker and all-round leader. I would like also to let you know, most reverend, that the Jacob Olanya has visited my village as well when he was deputy speaker. He visited my village. We had a meeting at home in my village. We had a meeting in a primary school with the children. And he also promised that as a speaker, deputy speaker then, he had gathered all the issues of Katakwi and he would help me solve them.
In the same vein, the Speaker of the 11th Parliament, Anita Annette Among, called on the father of her predecessor to believe in her as Jacob Olanya's sister.
I don't want you to feel like you've been left behind. I was a twin sister to Jacob, and I can pledge before all the thousands of people that I'll be there for you at home and will support the family. Apa Pladit Okor Nathan, Moti Kipeko, Amoru Onunduch, on the laws of Jacob. Jacob Abedomina, Antie Latini, Abimede Kikonyi, in all situations.
The Omoro District LC5 Chairperson Okello Douglas Peter Okao says the district has lost its pillar. He also requests government to honor its pledges and pay attention to the legacy of the man who left his party to further the interests of the country.
We are mourning our pillar. The late Jacob Olanya was a pillar to the people of Omoro District, the people of Northern Uganda and Uganda. We have lost that pillar. We are mourning today. The late Jacob Olanya was a shape under which the people of Omoro District, the people of Northern Uganda, seek refuge under.
While the woman member of parliament for Omoro District, Catherine Lamwaka, acknowledged that the death of Olanya is a great loss to the young leaders. She also declared forgiveness for the people who demonstrated after the government chartered a plane to fly the sick Jacob Olanya to the United States of America for specialized treatment.
Jacob Olanya was on his hospital bed fighting for his life. We stand to condemn such attitude, but above all, as a mother, I want to say we are forgiven. The Lord wants us to forgive, we are forgiven. We pray that we should learn to move together as a country. The death of Right Honorable Jacob Olanya brought us all together. It's important for us now to move together as a country.
However, the Acholi parliamentary group want further investigations into the death of the former Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya.
The President talked about arresting people who have mentioned the issue about these people when the Right Honorable Jacob has been killed. I want to address yourself. Don't arrest the people, but investigate. Otherwise, we will miss the point.
The Chief Justice, Alfonso Winidolo Chigamoy, called on his people to accept that physically, Jacob Olanya is no more.
I have given my word. I reiterate here. Jacob's children will pursue their education for as far as their brains will take them. And I'm happy, I'm glad, I thank God. There are thousands of like-minded people in this regard. And I believe this is the best way of wiping away the tears from Mzee Okori's face. The knowledge that yes, Jacob is dead, but Jacob is not dead. Because in my culture, you don't die if you have children.
Joseph Omagor, the news in Omoro.